Can you live without a brain? Well, you might think the most obvious answer to that is no, but if you want to get technical, it's definitely not impossible to live without a brain. And we're going to tell you how right now on Life's Biggest Questions. Hello and welcome back to LBQ. I'm Charlotte Dobre. Don't forget to like and subscribe and let us know in the comments below what topics you would like to see next. And I also just wanted to let you know that you can support this channel by donating to our Patreon page. So please check out the description for a link to find out what's in it for you. So let's talk about the brain. The brain serves as the center of the nervous system. It is the most complex organ in a vertebrate's body. It contains approximately 15 to 33 billion neurons, which control most processes in the body that facilitate life. You may assume that there's no way anyone could live without the most complex organ in our bodies, but you would be wrong. You can survive and live almost a normal life if you're missing most of your brain. According to a 2007 study, doctors examined a 44-year-old man who lived a normal life, even though he had an extremely tiny brain. Earlier this year, a case was reported where a woman was missing her entire cerebellum, yet she graduated, got married, and has a child. The cerebellum contains half of your brain cells, and she didn't even know it was missing. The important functions in our brain are not designated to just one region, but are supported by several regions. So if one part of the brain stops working, or if you're born without it, the rest of the brain can take on the job. This phenomenon is called neuroplasticity. So what about if someone is missing their entire brain? Like, I'm talking the whole thing. Can a person live then? There is a rare condition called hydranencephaly, where a child is born without the cerebral hemispheres. The cerebral hemispheres make up the shape of your brain. In someone with this condition, the brain is replaced by sacs filled with cerebrospinal fluid. There is no known cure or treatment for this condition, but it allows you to live with only a brain stem, not a full brain. Kalisha Barrett was born with hydranencephaly, and she lived to be 60 years old without a functioning brain. Another boy, Trevor Judge Waltrip, was born with the same condition, and he lived to be 12 years old, even though his doctor said he wouldn't live past 12 weeks. Trevor was unable to communicate and was also blind, but he did respond to some forms of basic stimulus. According to his mother, he hated being alone. The brainstem controls autonomic functioning like breathing and maintaining blood pressure. This means that you can live without your cerebral cortex, the part of the brain that controls higher functioning processes like memory, speech, and personality. So in short, it is possible to live without a large chunk or your whole brain, but it's not possible to live without a brain stem. So what about someone who has lost use of their brain, like someone in a coma, or someone that's become brain dead? Can a person survive then? Well, sort of. There have been cases of comatose people who do not need a machine to breathe, which technically means they are still alive. There have been recorded cases of people waking up from a coma after 10 years to lead a normal life. But if the person is totally brain dead, there is no chance they will ever be brought back to life. However, the heart's electrical system can keep itself beating for a short time after a person becomes brain dead. Kidney and gastric functions can continue working for weeks after being declared officially brain dead. But without a ventilator to move the blood and oxygen through a person's body, a heart beating would stop very quickly. It's not certain how long the body of a brain dead person can function. In the 1950s, 6 patients in France were kept alive for up to 26 days without blood flow to the brain. It is believed that with the help of ventilators, the body of a brain dead person could be kept alive for quite some time, maybe even indefinitely. But the longer you keep a person on life support, the higher the risk that tissue will become infected. That is all for this episode of Life's Biggest Questions. Thank you so much for watching. If you like this video and would like to go on a quest for more answers, on the screen right now you'll see a link to one of our playlists, Biggest Science Questions. That's it for me, and thanks for watching LBQ.